I've been covering film for almost 4 years now, and this is our first time we've ever had a chance to talk. So I will tell you open by saying it's an honor to sit across from you.
Thank you very much.
I absolutely love your work, and you're just one of the best actors on the screen.
Thank you.
I will also want to say that what a mustache in this movie. That thing was mighty nice. It was zeroed in. I'm like, that's a nice stash.
That's a good tash, isn't it? Yeah. No, well, you know, had to be done. I wanted to be able to tug at it and play with it during. So, yeah, there were a few months of growth involved in that.
How emotional of a role was this for you?
This is raw. This is raw in every aspect. You know, this is about America. It's about individuals. It's about overcoming hatred and bigotry. It's about how to stop hatred. It's about the frustrations of the political winds of change in Washington, where they are in no danger themselves, but are rendering potentially the deaths of loved ones absolutely meaningless. It's a look at why the hell we continue, and it's become relevant now, this very year, more so than we ever would have expected, about why in America are we continuing to see such division and such comfort in expressing hatred towards fellow Americans when the whole ideology and the whole beauty of America and the rest of the world recognizes it. Why are we missing the point? Is that it is a melting pot that is inviting to all and celebrates our differences instead of literally and figuratively wanting to put up walls between ourselves.
Right. It's set in 1892, but the parallels are definitely there, like you just explained. Yeah. You're a pretty good horse rider, too. I know you've ridden in other roles, but is this something you do on a regular basis?
It's not something I do on a regular basis, but my family had to make a quick getaway from England. I won't go into, but quite a funny story. When I was younger, and met an eccentric lady who just let me take a horse, and she said, "All right, get on a rope in a lunging paddock," and I rode bareback, and I stood up, and I lay sideways, and all that. And then she would say, "All right, go take the horse," and I would ride the horse down to the beach, and it would gallop. And this was 80s, and I was 11, and I would go tether the horse outside of a restaurant, and I would go drink a beer, and they didn't care that I was 11 and drinking a beer. And then I would get on the horse and fall asleep, and the horse would walk home. So I've always felt comfort on a horse. My technique is probably not that good, but I feel very comfortable.
Look good to me. We have a thing in Houston in February, March called Rodeo Houston. I'm going to sign you up. You can come compete.
As long as I can tether it up and have a beer.
Sure.
And then fall asleep on my way home.
Final question for you. What do you want for Christmas this year?
What do I want for Christmas? Well, I want my daughter to let me start dirt biking again. That's what I want. Santa, let that happen, please. I've been waiting for years. She still won't let me. Understandably, I'm full of metal. But I want a dirt bike, Santa, please. Not a dirt bike, I have one. It's sitting right there. I want to be able to dirt bike, Santa, please.